This one interview is being taken in relation to a traffic fatality.
They had gone to the beach. It was a rainy day, so they were headed north to Jacksonville to spend the rest of the day. They had had, obviously, something to drink.
911, what is the address of the emergency?
A car come out of nowhere, out hit us, run us off the road, caught the right tail end of a Lexus.
Okay.
Spun her around in oncoming traffic, and that's when the other green car hit her.
I didn't say because you've had too much drink. I said maybe you should pull over and wait a little bit. And then I was closing my eyes and screaming because I was scared. And I think maybe he just thought I was being a girl, okay. But I was scared.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can be used against you in court. You have the right to talk to a lawyer for advice before I ask you any questions and to have him with you during questioning.
I couldn't believe that I was losing the last person I had. My best friend, my only family, and she was taken from me that quickly without me getting to say goodbye, without me getting to say anything. And it was like she was just stolen from me. It's just not fair. She didn't get to see me have a child. She didn't get to see me have a family of my own. She wasn't, she was just taken from me.
A piece of my heart was ripped out. I wouldn't wish what I've been through or what I witnessed so many other people been through on anyone.
So, if you drink and drive, and you're going to prom, and you're a high school senior, you're going to be charged as an adult, more than likely, and you're going to come before a judge. And the very minimum that you score on a sentencing guideline score sheet is 10 and a half years, with no prior record. And so, these kids who are 16, 17 years old, 10 and a half years is more than half of the life that they've already lived. And I don't think they think about that.
I think people understand how easy it is to get caught up into something like this. I certainly never thought it would be. I've talked to damn near everybody I talk to about it says, that could have been me. I've drunk, they go on to tell a story about, the time that they drank and drove and did something that they shouldn't have done. I wish I could go back and change what I did. I wish I could do it more than I think you guys understand.
Daniel Rocha was young, had his whole life in front of him. His life is now, for all intents and purposes, ruined. He will rebuild parts of it. He'll struggle the rest of his life with the guilt of what he's done. He'll struggle with the rest of his life of being a convicted felon and not receiving chances for employment, opportunities for student loans, and these effects will follow him for his entire life. And he didn't mean to hurt anybody. He was out on a date.
Oh yeah, that's her right here. Yeah, she's got another drink here, you see? Right here?
Yep.
Uh-huh.
Very clearly in her hands.
Right, that's her. In half an hour, her life is gonna turn upside down, and someone's gonna be dead. You see, and here's where she drops something again. And then they come back, and that's when they leave, and they go to the parking lot.
Thank you.
was almost on the sidewalk when this vehicle around 50 to 60 miles an hour hit Stefano and threw him up in the air at a high rate of speed, and he hit the floor and basically his head burst on the pavement. There was blood everywhere. It was a horrific scene.
Frantic 911 calls when a driver took off after hitting and killing 41-year-old chef Stefano Ricciarelli outside the Shelbourne Hotel on 18th and Collins Avenue.
I'm actually just following a car that just hit a man on Collins Avenue. As far as I know, this man, he must have killed him, you know?
Police say calls from a witness helped them catch 20-year-old Carly Tomica at her apartment complex, where the witness followed her nearly 40 blocks north of the crash.
The lady is really drunk and just came out of the car.
The man who tracked Tomica down did not say much about following her.
I talked to the police and they said that I wasn't supposed to talk to anyone.
This good Samaritan helped us out not only immediately finding this person and getting her off the road, but in the future when she goes to trial and help prosecute her and getting her put in jail where she belongs.
Officers have charged Tomica with leaving the scene of an accident involving death.
How is it possible? Because Stefano is not the kind of guy that dies. Stefano is immortal, he's strong, he's healthy. You can't just die. Something has happened. What happened? And then they told me about it. In that moment, I crashed because my thought went to, how am I going to tell my kids they lost their dad? How am I going to do this? How are you going to tell your kids they lost their dad all of a sudden? It's not something you just say.
The self-described party princess arrested, blew 3 times the legal limit. It was a brutal hit and run. She did not even stop when a good Samaritan tried to flag her down.
Driving away and leaving him to die was inexcusable.
Her appearance much different. Carly Tomica gets a plea deal. Lawyers and state prosecutors encouraged by the victim, Stefano Ricciarelli's wife.
What will you do with this opportunity? Will you waste it, or will you dedicate your life to improving the life of others and not destroying them?
And that opportunity, sentenced as a youthful offender, 4 years in prison, 2 years home detention, 15 years probation, never drive again.
I know that my actions utterly shattered the hearts of his wife, his children, his friends, and all who knew him.
I will never forget their faces. I will never forget them. I'm so sorry. It's just impossible to imagine the pain that they felt at that moment. It's just something that will stay with them forever. We try to make them express their feeling. We try to make them talk about it. We made them really part of the conversation.
Time with my family. I worked 3 jobs in high school. I had everything that I ever wanted. Great family, a good boyfriend, decent job, good grades, great friends. And now I'm in prison without any of that. I can talk to my family for 15 minutes every day. I haven't seen them in 2 months. I haven't seen my boyfriend in 2 months. Some of my friends write me, not all of them. They're too busy.
Drinking and driving is just a formula waiting for a disaster. You don't want to be that disaster. You don't want your parents to suffer. You don't want your parents to have to mortgage their homes, to cry every night because you did something wrong, because you drank and you drove. You don't want your mom and your dad to think forever that you might be in prison, that you might always be a convicted felon, that you may never be able to drive again. Your life will never be the same. Don't make them suffer. Don't drink and drive, please. If you won't do it for a potential victim, do it for yourself and do it for your family.